morning, everyone. Everyone here in our Mount Zion parking lot and our Facebook and YouTube friends. Good morning. Glad to have all of you with us. Let's begin with a song. God of Grace and God of Glory. If you have a Lutheran Book of Worship, it's number 415. And if you don't at home, you can just Google God of Grace and God of Glory. And you can see the lyrics, and we're only singing two verses, the first two. Enjoy. Thanks, guys. Beautiful. Let's continue our worship by trusting in the mercy of God to confess our sin. Beloved of God, all your sins are forgiven. Let us live now in hope, for hope does not disappoint, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Beloved and sovereign God, through the death and resurrection of your Son, you bring us into your kingdom of justice and mercy. By your Spirit, give us your wisdom, that we may treasure the life that comes from Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Reading for today is, we have one reading, it's from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 13, verses 31 through 33, verses 44 through 52. Jesus put before the crowds another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that someone took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, but when it has grown, it is the greatest of shrubs, and becomes a tree so that the birds of the air come and make nests in its branches. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in with three measures of flour until all of it was leavened. The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field, which someone found and hid. Then in his joy, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant in search of fine pearls. On finding one pearl of great value, he went and sold all that he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was thrown into the sea and caught fish of every kind. When it was full, they drew it ashore, sat down, and put the good into baskets, but threw out the bad. So it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come out and separate the evil from the righteous and throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all this? They answered, yes. He said to them, "Therefore, every scribe who has been trained for the kingdom of heaven is like the master of a household who brings out his treasure, what is new and what is old." Here ends the reading. The COVID-19 pandemic has shown us, in so many ways, how something so small and invisible to the eye can grow rapidly and exponentially into a destructive force that consumes all our attention and resources, not only as individuals and communities, but as nations and as a world. But I'm here to say that the gospel lesson for today offers a counter image to that destructive force. The parables told us to us by Jesus describe how the kingdom of heaven emerges from something almost invisible to the eye, and it grows exponentially, offering us treasure worthy of all of our attention and resources. Where can we find that counter image of the kingdom of heaven? Jesus tells us we can find it in small and treasured gifts, like a mustard seed, yeast, hidden treasures in a field, a pearl of great value, and a net that gains a great catch. Remember all those times when we prayed, "Your kingdom come"? Well, it's here. And even though it may feel like we're living in a field of COVID-19 sorrows, God's kingdom is present right now and awaiting our joyful discovery. But you know, when you read through this lesson from Matthew, the grouping of so many small sayings together in the gospel can make it challenging for us to focus, as each of those five images have an element of surprise. So this morning, I just want to focus on one of these metaphors, the mustard seed. You know, the mustard seed is tiny. I looked it up. It's only 0.04 of an inch in diameter. That's tiny. Insignificant in size, yet it's sown by someone in a field. As it grows into a mustard bush, it's not a stately tree, or even a well-manicured, tightly clipped shrub. The truth is, the mustard seed produces a straggly bush that usually grows wild. It's an ill-mannered, bushy, homely plant that no one would pick to landscape in their garden. Right, Jim? Apparently, this is not a problem for Jesus. Sturdy trunks, gorgeous flowers, and well-behaved branches matter not to this divine gardener. What seems to impress Jesus is simply the fact that the shrub grows and grows and grows, and is also strong enough to help other living things, like birds who build their family with a nest of eggs in this mustard bush. God takes these tiny mustard seeds that are planted by the Holy Spirit, first invisible to our eyes, and he blesses them and he uses them in the kingdom of God as a wildly successful farm whose blessings cannot be contained. For example, who would think that buying a quart of chicken corn soup would net enough profits to buy complete holiday dinners for 34 Monroe School families at Thanksgiving and Christmas? Think about for a second the thousands of families who have been helped by this soup sale over the decades, feeding people with food insecurity, living right here in our neighborhood. The same is true when you donate non-perishable food that we collect year-round that goes to New Hope Ministries and to help people who have fallen on hard times. During a global pandemic, the smallest of food donations are more important than ever before. And then consider the donations that we give to make school and personal care kits every year for Lutheran World Relief. When we donate something as tiny as a 25-cent notebook, or we buy a towel from the dollar store to be included in one of these kits, we're helping families who are living around the world to thrive and sometimes survive. And just to add one more note, we've already begun planning the 5th annual SeaPark event. This year, the 3-mile fun run is going to be a virtual fundraiser. Details to follow. But please know that the goal is the same. It benefits the residents of our local SeaPark church town home that really is probably no more than a couple tenths of a mile away from where I'm standing. God takes our tiny little mustard seeds and cultivates them and grows these ministries in our church. And that's all so we can share the kingdom of heaven with others. Because this good news is not for us alone. We're to share it. There's no need to sit idle during this pandemic. We may not do everything that we've hoped to this year, but there's still a lot of ministry to be done during these challenging times. We are still able to do a world of good with our tiny mustard seeds, and they provide so many blessings to families near and far so they can grow stronger and recover. Our gospel text reminds us today that God is bigger than any pandemic, and the kingdom of heaven will not be stopped and is emerging right in front of us. And that's a promise we can all embrace. Amen. Let's continue our worship with another song, Be Thou My Vision. It's in the With One Voice hymnal, if you have it, the blue hymnal, number 776. If not, I'm sure you can Google Be Thou My Vision, and we're going to sing only the first two verses. Thanks, everyone. Let's continue with the prayers of the people. From our many locations, yet held in one body by the Holy Spirit, we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. For the church, O God of mercy, we pray. Open your word to Christians around the world. Reveal yourself in ways both traditional and surprising, in places old and new. Bless our bishops, pastors, and other church leaders as they face their challenging tasks. Turn to us, O God. Be gracious to us. For education and nurture in the church, O God of wisdom, we pray. Give us the will to seek your wisdom. Guide the many churches in their uses of technology. And show us during this time ways to study your word. Accompany all church musicians as they seek to help the church offer its praise. Turn to us, O God. Be gracious to us. For the earth, O creative God, we pray. Give the plants and animals the water and land they require. Form us into grateful and healing caretakers of your earth. Bless the efforts of scientists and researchers, especially those seeking a vaccine. Turn to us, O God. Be gracious to us. For the nations of God of justice, we pray. Direct leaders of nations to build trust with each other. Resist the ways of violence and bring peace to the world. Move us away from racist attitudes and policies. Form our government to speak with honesty, to strive for justice, and to work to alleviate the nation's needs. Turn to us, O God. Be gracious to us. For all in need, O God of compassion, we pray. Heal the sick. Feed the hungry. Comfort the countless thousands who are dealing with this coronavirus. Accompany those living with anxiety and despair. We especially pray for those we name aloud now or in our hearts. Turn to us, O God. Be gracious to us. For the youth, O God of grace, we pray. Give to all youth an inspiring dream of what their future might be and patience to await a time of safety. Direct all schools from daycare through graduate school to find an acceptable way forward. Turn to us, O God. Be gracious to us. In gratitude for the lives of our beloved dead, we pray that nothing, neither death nor life, will separate us from your love. At the end, gather us with all your saints in light everlasting. Turn to us, O God. Be gracious to us. Into your hands, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Now, won't you pray with me the prayer that Jesus taught us? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our final hymn for this morning is My Faith Looks Up to Thee. If you have the green Lutheran Book of Worship, it's number 479. If you need to Google it, again, the title is My Faith Looks Up to Thee. And again, we're singing just the first two verses.
Now in the world, I pray.
Thanks, everyone. And now we conclude our service with a blessing for all. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Stay cool and stay healthy. Thanks be to God.